Okay, so I have just gessoed a couple of canvases for some projects that I'm going to be working on for the next 2 weeks. And while they're drying, I was cleaning up my studio and I have a bunch of Amazon boxes and Dick Blick boxes that I was just fixing to throw away. And I thought, what can I do with these? I'd rather not throw them away. I'd rather do something with them. And I thought about doing some organization for my paints and turning these boxes into some storage containers or holders. So I made this one. This one's an actual box. But what I think I'm going to do for my paints is basically the same concept without lids. So these are, I'm going to make some stuff that will hold my paints and some paint brushes. And that way I can organize my studio while I let my gesso dry on my canvases. So to do this, you're going to need obviously cardboard, a paper trimmer. You can also use an X-Acto knife or a box cutter. Some cardboard that I've cut off the box. This is one of the flaps. And some hot glue. Oops. And a marker. I think that's going to be all we're going to need. So to get started, I'm going to make a box for my tall paint brushes, and I'm going to make, oh, my hands are a mess. I'm going to make some for my shorter paint brushes, like this size, and then I'm going to make some for my taller paint brushes, and then I'm also going to make a duplicate set for oils and acrylics, since I paint in both and I have paint brushes in both. But this is how my paint brushes are stored. They're stored in a Folgers plastic container, and it's very unorganized. So I'm going to see if I can make these little boxes. It's actually very quick and easy to make them. But first, I need to decide. This is my straight edge, and this is the edge I cut off the box. So I'm going to use the straight edge, and I'm going to decide how tall, not all of my paint, well, they're all about the same height, I think. Let's see. Okay. So I want them, the box to be about halfway. And I want the box to be a 4x4x4. No, 4x4x whatever this measurement is going to be. And I think, so I'm just going to mark where I want the box to come up on the paintbrush. So first I'm going to cut this edge of this paper is kind of crooked and crushed a little bit. Oops. So I'm going to grab my paper trimmer. And the first thing, I don't have a whole lot of room on here, let's see. The first thing I'm going to do is take my straighter edge, which has tape and stuff on it. I'm not even worried about the tape or the label that's down here. You see, I've got part of a label, I've got some tape from the packing. I'm not even going to worry about that. What I need to do is just cut this kind of damaged edge off first. On this trimmer, it's easier if we go from that side. So now I have a straight edge that I can use to space here. Now, I know that I want the box to be 4x4 square. Kind of like this one. Just a 4x, this one, I'm gonna make one taller than this, but. So, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this at 8 inches, and then I'm gonna cut it again at 4 inches. Then I'm gonna cut off, well, let's see, I'm gonna first cut 8 inches. And if you're curious, this is a Fiskars rotary cutter, which is pretty nice cutter. It just makes this a lot easier. Now I'm gonna cut where my mark was. I'm gonna cut, you can see it, I'm gonna line it up and I'm gonna cut it off. That's gonna cut this piece off. So now I have the height of my box, and then I need to cut this. We've got it at the, let's see, what is the height of this box? The height of this box is gonna be, right at 6, let's see, that is 6, and of course it's right at the fold in the table, or fold in this, you know, so it makes it hard to measure. It looks like 6 3/8 is what it looks like. But we're gonna cut this down to 4 inches on the 6 3/8 side. Now our pieces should be about the same size. It's not perfect, it's not a huge deal, you just want it as close as you can get it. So we're going to cut, this is going to be my other two pieces. This is my straight edge, and then I have another straight edge here. Well, it looks like both of these, yeah, so both of these are straight. And this side straight. This is the side I cut off the box. But I think I am still going to cut this edge off to make sure I have a straight edge to start with as possible to do my measurements from. So we're going to do, if you're not real sure how tall you need to make it, another kind of easy way to cheat is line it up, grab your marker, or pen or pencil, whatever, marking device, and mark it and cut it. That way you, since my measurement, it's real hard for me to read what my measurement is when it comes to the middle of this tray, so, because this folds right here. Now we're going to cut this at the 8-inch, because now we have it at the right height. Now we need to cut it at 8 inches, and then we'll cut it again at 4 inches. And then we will have our two sides. Seems off to me. Let's see. Nope, it's perfect. So now we have our two sides that are 4 inches 6 3/8 was the size I wanted. You could do 6.5 and probably make it a lot easier. Now I need the base. So the base, I just need it to be a 4x4. So we're gonna do 4 inches. And again by 4 inches. Let's see, what side do I want to cut off this? So cut this side off. And there we go. We're done with our cutting blade. These are just strips. Now we're going to need our hot glue gun and our 4 pieces and the base piece. So these are our side pieces and our base pieces. It doesn't matter if the you can see the lines on the cardboard that kind of tells you which way the cells are going inside. It doesn't matter. So here's our base, and I'm going to make sure that the tape, this, I don't know if you can see it, there's tape on here. There you go. You can kind of see the packing tape on there. I'm just going to put this to the bottom. You can do it to the inside too, then you would never see it. Let's just do that. And then we're going to just look and see. That looks pretty good. So we're just going to put some hot glue gun on this edge, the very bottom, right along this inside, and then we're going to push this against the base piece. So your base piece is flat, and this is going to push up against the outside of it. And try not to glue it to your table. Give that a second to dry. Now, what I would suggest is going ahead and running a bead of glue on the inside. And I kind of push into that crack. And I use the barrel, push that real quick. I use the barrel of the gun because it's so hot, it will actually melt the glue along the side and kind of help smooth out those, that glue. Then we'll get another piece, and we're gonna, let's get that out of the way, we're gonna glue right along this bottom edge. And again, we're just going to push it up against the base piece. Make sure it's sitting on the ground. That a second to kind of bond. I keep gluing it to my table. Then we're going to run a bead of glue. I don't know if you can see that. We're going to run a bead of glue right in this corner also. Now we have, the lighting in here is terrible right now. I had to turn off my, let me see if I turn on a different light, if that will help. little bit. So I've got a bead of glue on each corner. See it very well. Now, here's the tricky part. We cut these at the same height as these sides, but we cut them at 4 inches, which means our base is 4 inches, but when you glue these two pieces to the base, your base is now about a quarter of an inch wider, because my boxes are about an eighth of an inch thick. So now you've got an eighth of an inch and an eighth of an inch added to both sides, where this is still only at 4 inches. So you can't glue this piece to the outside edge. You have to glue it to the inside edge. So you have to push it inside here, which when you do that is going to make it too tall. So now, let's see if I move this around, if you can see, now it's standing up too tall. So what we're going to do to remedy that is snug it up in here. I think I'll flip this around a couple. Let's do it this way. I'm just going to push it into the base. This is how we want it to sit in there. Grab your marker and just mark on the side how much you need to cut off. And you pretty much only have to do it to the one piece. And I'll show you how we're going to cut that one without having to mark that one. You can mark it if you want to, but I'll just show you a shortcut. Because these are our own little personal boxes, it doesn't really matter if there's, if they're not absolutely perfect. This is just to create some cute storage recycled boxes. So I'm gonna move this over here. Now this is my other base piece, and I'm gonna line those up. Let me dry fit this real quick. Yep, and you can see now it's perfect. So we're gonna dry fit these two pieces together and line them up to where the bottoms line up perfectly. Then we're going to take and just mark where we need to cut off. So now I know that I need to cut that much off. This up here. That's lined up. And now our two pieces, yep, should be the exact same size. Okay, so now we need these to fit in here like this. So we're going to actually glue the three edges of it. So I just start at one side. You do want to work a little fast on here. Let's see. And you're going to shove it in there and line it all up, making sure that it's flush to the table. And then while the other side, let's go ahead. Where's my glue band? Give me any slack here. We're going to go ahead and glue the corners. Of course, when you do that, it starts melting your glue again, because that barrel is hot and it will melt the glue you already put on, but that's okay, just hold it. Get it in there and then hold it. Now to do this side, just dry fit it real fast. I'm going to make sure, for my end, I have tape on this end, so I'm going to make sure that goes on the bottom and on the inside. This way, I'm just going to set it in there. You can still set it on your tabletop, which I find easier. Set it and then press it down to make sure that it's flush. That'll just make sure that all your edges are flush, and then I got all these glue strings everywhere. Again. You might want to make sure you have the protective table. This is a plastic tabletop, so the glue just comes off pretty easy. So it's going to be harder to get your gun in there to do that corner, but get in there as best you can. Do that corner. Oops. Lift it out of there again. Glue is hot. So I'm using just a piece of the cardboard that we cut off to help get in there and smear that glue around into that into that corner. Better. Okay, that looks good. Blow on it. Now I'm going to do this corner the same way. And I'm going to use this to smear that in there. Alright. You can see how fast this goes. So now what I'm going to do is, there's all these holes from the cardboard edge, and I don't really want those to show. So I'm going to put a bead of glue along this edge. And then I'm going to take the barrel of my gun, which is hot, and I'm going to smooth that into those holes. And if you can still see the holes, just keep adding more glue and just keep smearing it back and forth. Then you'll want to take your gun and go down this edge. That'll melt that side and kind of push it back into those holes. And what we're trying to do is just seal those holes off. I don't know if it, that's really hard to see, isn't it? There we go. And now we're going to do this side the same way. This is also going to help strengthen up that box. And we're going to run it along this edge to melt that glue that kind of hangs over. And there we go. Now we'll do the bottom. And if you have glue that's already dried from you can just, if you set this barrel against it, it'll melt it. That's a good way to clean up that edge. And there we go. Then we're gonna get that side set up a second. One thing nice about hot glue is it dries pretty fast. So now we're gonna do the bottom. Just sealing those open cells on the, when you get your corners, use the barrel of your gun to kind of smooth everything out so you don't have any raised spots of glue. And we're going to do this side. Still got some that are open. So you just keep building that glue up, eventually it'll seal those holes off. My dog is in here and she's having dreams. You can hear her. Now we'll do this other side. Having little puppy dreams. Just kind of barking. This edge. We're just doing this to all of the sides that have these open holes on the side of the box. Until we get a smooth corner, smooth edges. You could also like paper mache over the whole piece. To kind of get a better finish. But I'm going to paint these black and then airbrush just like I did that other one. That box I showed you in the beginning. That's what I did with that one. So I'm not really concerned about it. Okay, so that all feels dry enough. Now I'm going to do the top edge. This is the Starving Artist way to make paintbrush holders and paint organizers. If you have any running down the side, just use the barrel of your gun to smooth out your edges. Because the heat of this gun, the heat of the barrel will melt this glue back down to liquid. Alright. And there we go. We just need to let that set up. And I'm going to go and make several more. I'm going to make a longer one that's short and a shorter one that's square for paintbrushes. And I'll show you how to do those too. It'll be the same process, but I'll record how I make them.